perfectly competitive market. In reality, fine, you can't say there's no 100% perfectly competitive market, but that is the best. Monopoly market, monopolized market, pure monopoly, you have market. Today we will finish this discussion on competitive market. When you say competitive market, perfect competition. The last week we just defined what is a market first. The players of the market, buyer, seller, and the some markets you are intermediaries, stock brokers, right? Some market you can see the buyer and the seller physically, but stock market you can't see. Then the market structure. What is the market structure? Structure of the structure of market is description of buyers. How many buyers? How many sellers? Whether there are some entry exit conditions? What about the information flow? Both kind of buyer and the seller, do they have the perfect information about the product? Then the what about the nature of the product? Whether it is different product, product homogeneous, or the differentiation is there, or the identical product is there, or we discuss. That is the market structure. We explain the description about this number of buyers, number of sellers. Whether buyer is a price setter or the price taker, seller is a price setter or the price taker. Are there the entry exit barriers to the market? Market is the industry. Industry producing the same product, right? So the entry exit barriers, nature of the product. Some product perfect substitutes. One for output of one firm is perfect substitute for the output of the other one. But for example, it's a toothpaste. They are not perfect substitutes. Signal and clock guard, they are not perfect substitutes. They are different. Then the information about this, whether the about the quality of the product, quality, content of the product, durability of the product. So the information available or not, right? So therefore, depending on those variable, in terms of with regard to these variables, we can identify basically five market structures. Perfectly competitive market structure, monopolist, monopsonist, then you have the oligopoly, monopolistic competition. Industries, banking industry, oligopoly market, paddy producing the sector, perfectly competitive market structure, CB, distribution of electricity, CB, monopoly, right? Central bank, the banking sector, central bank, there one central bank. The apex institutions, the that manage, regulate the issue circulars to the banking financial institutions, right? And monopolistic competition like that. Then we discuss about the it's a comparison. All the market structures, buyers are price takers. Perfect competition, monopoly, monopolistic competition, oligopoly is a product market. But there's one particular market structure that is called monopsony. Buyer is the price setter, price maker. But other than in the product market, output market, buyers are price takers. But the sellers, some markets, price, seller is a price taker. Monopoly market, seller is a price maker. Monopolistic competition, seller is a price maker. Oligopoly, seller is price maker, yes, price maker. Then entry condition. Competitive market, no entry exit barriers. Entry is free, exit is free. Monopoly, entry is blocked. Either technological barriers or administrative by law, or it is legal barriers are there, completely blocked. No other firm can enter, start producing the same product, right? So the electricity distribution, the electricity board mainly, right? So therefore, the entry into the market, monopolistic competition, free entry exit, free entry exit. Oligopoly market, entry into the market may be blocked or free. For example, banking industry is an example for the oligopoly market structure. The if you want to study the start a bank, you can't do that. There are so many regulation, legal requirements to be fulfilled. Central bank, the requirements, capital requirements are there. Central bank inspection, central bank bank supervision department should approve the location. Then they check the board of directors, their age structure, then what type of products they are using, their interest rate structure. Yeah. Very comprehensive evaluation process are there. These are some barriers, right? So these are restrictions are there, right? Therefore we say entry into the market may be blocked or is free, right? Oligopoly market. Then strategic behavior. This product market, except the oligopoly market, the all other in all other markets, firms, players, suppliers do not behave strategically. Only oligopoly market firms behave strategically. Strategic behavior is there, right? Excuse me. Paper again, excuse me. Are the papers correct? Correct? Can you pull on the ground? Okay. Okay. Then discuss competitive market structure definitions, the properties of the characteristic of the competitive market structure, the no product differentiation, then the presence of large number of firms, the perfect information, entry exit free, homogeneous product, like that. Then we discuss industry and the firm. Industry or the market, price is determined by the interaction between all the consumers and all the suppliers. Downward sloping demand curve, upward sloping supply. They determine the price. If you take one firm, this firm should accept that price, take that price. Firm is a price taker and produce whatever the amount. So then the demand curve faced by the firm. How does the firm get an idea about the demand? Demand is perfectly elastic demand. They can produce any amount, 10 kilograms, 20 kilograms, 1000 kilograms of the output, but the selling price, unit price is the market price. That's why we call firm is a price taker. Firm is a price taker. Then we discuss how does the price elasticity of demand, it's a small question, how does the firm decide the profit maximizing output? Now this demand curve is horizontal. We proved that it is equal to MR curve. MR curve, demand curve, it is the price line. It is perfectly elastic. Elasticity infinity. Then this is MR. Then profit maximizing output, like any other firm. Firm has to decide profit maximizing output. Objective is to maximize the profit, no? Then what should be, how much should I produce in order to get the maximum profit? Profit maximizing output. What is the rule? MR equals MC. MR equals MC. MC curve is not there, but MC curve, we know the shape of the MC curve. We have discussed U-shape MC curve. U-shape MC curve. And then MR equals MC at this point. Perfectly competitive market, that is price profit maximizing output, point of intersection of horizontal MR curve and the MC curve, that is the profit maximizing output. Then we discuss using the AC curve. This other below this U-shaped curve is AC curve. We discuss what is the maximum, the profit of that. This bigger area is, we said last week, it is the revenue. Small rectangle indicates the average cost into price quantity, that is the total cost. Then small area is the profit. Profit. Very nice diagram, nice model. The perfectly competitive market can be represented using this model. Horizontal MR curve, U-shape MC curve, U-shape AC curve. It's a nice model, very nice model. You can explain everything. You can indicate what is profit maximizing output, what is profits, what is average cost, like. Then firm's output, I think we discussed up to this point also. Yes, where the output decision in the short run. In the short run, we have the altogether four cost curves, but we have discussed only three cost curves: ABC, AC, MC curves. Price or the MR line, price of the MR curve is a variable. This P1, P2, P3 depend on the determined by the market structure. Market structure. In the initial market price is P1, when more suppliers are entered, market price decreases to P2. When more suppliers enter, market price further decreases to P3. Firm is a price taker. Firm taking price P1, they can decide profit maximizing output Q1. Taking price P2, they can decide Q2. Taking price P3, Q3. Now, we said P3 is given a special name that is called shutdown price. Why it is called shutdown price? If price decrease further below this P3, firm will not produce. This is the limiting price. If price falls below the PC, if market price falls below the shutdown point, firm does not produce, shut down the firm temporarily. So that the cutoff point is that. If price falls P3, they stop production. They don't produce. They don't produce shutdown price. As long as market price is above P3, they will produce. Firm will produce. If price is very high, P1, firm will produce Q1 at a profit. They can make profit with high price. But if price is between AC and ABC, below the AC, above the ABC, P2, below AC, above ABC. Therefore, because it is a less than AC, firm cannot make any profit, losses. But they produce, still produce. So that is interesting. Perfectly competitive market has two cases. Firm will produce at a profit, or firm will produce at a loss. Because this is in the short run, things will improve. Think about today you start a business. You can't make profit tomorrow, day after tomorrow. No. Month's time, maybe still you are losing. 2 months time, you are losing. You are between AC and ABC. But what will happen? When the market condition changes, demand increases, then the price might improve. Price will go up gradually. 3 months, 4 months time, price increases. Otherwise, you are making losses. You will be making losses for certain period. That period, that case, that the scenario is shown by this P2. You are making losses, but still you produce. Making losses, still you produce. So short run, firm has to take two decisions: produce at a profit, produce at a loss, shut down. Three decisions: produce at a profit, produce at a loss, shut down. Shutdown point is P3. Any questions up to this point about this? Then we discuss long run case. Sorry. Right. Any questions? Then this one. We worked out this, no? I think. Did we work out this example? Please, can you remember? Did we work out this example? No. Today we will discuss on these two, no? Did we discuss these two examples? Can you remember? Hello?
Yeah.
All four sections we discuss? All four sections? Yes, 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 we discuss, right. But next question, VD in type B. Short run AVCS. Here, I wanted you to discuss, yes. The prepare AC, PVC, MC schedules. Find a profit maximizing output if market price is 50. Estimate total profit. Graphically illustrate your finding. I think this, of course, you can do that. Easy. Prepare AC, TVC, and MC. These two questions are past paper questions, right? They're past paper. Fixed cost is 60. Fixed cost is 60. Quantity is easy. The best thing is to write this vertically. Then you can add the columns through AC, TVC, MC. You can calculate. Draw AC and MC curves in a graph. Find the profit maximize. I might do this. Yes. First, I'll copy this. Can you see the board now, please? Hello? Can you see the board? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Can you see the board? Yes. Yes. Right. Okay. Then everybody can see, I believe, board, right? Then the fixed cost is, then you can, first, average cost is TC divided by Q. TC over Q. 60 divided by 0, infinity. 100 divided by 1, 100. 130 divided by 2, 65. And then 55 divided by 3. And then 90 divided by 4. 140 divided by 4, 130 divided by 6, 110 divided by 4, 110 divided by 4. Listen, TVC, total variable cost, or VC or TVC, it doesn't matter when you say TVC or VC, same. Then, what is fixed cost? Tell me, what is fixed cost? Can you decide the fixed cost? Can one of you tell me what is fixed cost? Fixed cost is how much? Hello? You can see the board, I believe. You can. If you can't see, please tell me. Please tell me. What is fixed cost? Fixed cost? By looking at this table, you can decide. Can you tell me what is fixed cost?
60.
60. Good. Why is that? When firm does not produce any output, you'll have to incur cost. The cost corresponding when output is 0, 60, because it's 60. Then what is variable cost is TC minus FC. Let's take down FC also here. 60. Then we see TVC. TVC is difference between these two, 0. Difference between these two, 40. Difference between these two, 70. Difference between these two, 40 plus 55, 40 plus 55, 40 plus 55, 95. 60 minus 100, 930. So 240 minus 180, 180 plus 60 is 140. 310 minus 60, 310 minus 60 is 350. 350 plus 60, 410. Right, okay. MC, marginal cost is what? What is marginal cost? Marginal cost is change in cost. MC is change in cost divided by change in output. Total cost. This difference divided by this difference. This difference divided by this difference. Like that. 100 minus 60 divided by 1 minus 0. 40. 130 minus 100 divided by 2 minus 1. 30. 30 divided by 1, 30. 155 minus 130 divided by 3 minus 2. 155 minus 130 is 25. 25 divided by 1, 25. Yes. 190 minus 155 divided by 4 minus 3. 35. Then 240 minus 190. 50, yes. Yeah. 310 minus 240. 70. Then 410 minus, this is 100. Now we completed this table. AC, DVC, MC. Draw AC, MC curves in a graph. AC, MC curves in a graph. Draw this 1 to 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. AC, AVC. Both AC, ABC. Then you can mark these curves and check that whether it is like this. Okay. Now the drawing the graphs are very important. So in the examination paper, especially even online here, if you conduct the exam online or the physically you will come in, most of the papers you find this type of questions. Derive AC and ABC, draw AC and ABC, draw ABC and MC like that. So you should be able to plotting the graph. Should be familiar with this. But when I marked the exam answer scripts, some students find difficulties in drawing the graph, right? If you are not that much familiar with the drawing graph, just drop that part at least without the graph, because you are wasting time, right? They were struggling. But most of the students, they quickly draw the curves, plot, mark these points and draw the curve, right? That is easy. You can get marks, 5 marks, right? Then next question, find the profit maximizing output if market price is 50. Most important question. Market price 50. when market price 50, we have proved market price is equal to the marginal revenue. MR also 50. We proved MR equal 50, AR equal 50, the horizontal demand. Now, still you have not answered the question. Profit maximizing output is given by MR equals MC. MR or MC equals MR. So you have to find out the point output level where MR MC equal 50. MR 50, MC 50. MR 50, MC 50. MR 50, no, because price 50. Therefore, you have to find out the point where MC also 50. What is that point? MC 50. Point is this. MC 50 here. MC 50 here. So MR also 50, no? Then that conditions output level 5. Output level 5 is the profit maximizing output. Total profit. What is the profit? Profit is R minus TC. TC we know. TC is 240. TR is how much? Market price 50. Quantity 5. Market price 50. Quantity 5. 5 into 50. 250. TR equals market price 50 into output 5. 250. Total cost is 240. Therefore, profit is 10. Profit is 10. Finish. Now we are graphically illustrate your findings. You have to draw a graph. Draw the graph. You know, you remember this graph. Sorry. Don't it's not according to the scale, you just draw a graph. Remember this graph? Quantity versus MR, the MC, AC, or the price. Price 50. This is MR. T equals MR equals 50. MR equals 50. Then MC. Profit maximizing output. Where is profit maximizing output? MR equals MC. 5. Profit maximizing output 5. Then average cost, because you have to indicate the profit. Average cost is this. Average cost curve is like this. No? What is the average cost of this output? Average cost is 48. Average cost 48. What is average cost? Average cost 48. Now we can see 50 into 5, 250 total revenue. Total cost, average cost into 5, 48 into 5, 240. 48 into 5 is 240. Then profit is 10. This is the profit. There is a diagram. Complete diagram. Right? That is a complete diagram. Okay, you can draw that. So we have answered. Now this is a past paper question. Typical the past paper question, standard question, data table is given. You are asked to calculate AC, AVC, MC, or sometimes any other ratio, the concept, then determine the profit maximizing output at a given price. Now earlier, 45 market price, we determine the profit maximizing output. This time market price is 50. This is the key. Because it is a competitive market, perfectly competitive market, MR is 50. Price equals MR. Then profit maximizing output is determined by MC also 50. Profit maximizing output. Please work out this example again. Do yourself and understand. Now this is a typical question that you can expect the paper. So I'm thinking I have the last paper now, the September paper. January paper examination, January 2021. Next week I will upload this 2021 paper, and you can discuss. You can discuss this. I just now got this one here. Yeah. Okay. Next week, I am going to upload this and discuss some of the questions. Mike, now we have already done most of the questions. We can discuss this. Right. Okay. Now, this is short run behavior. Now we move to how does the competitive firm in this industry determine profit maximizing output in the long run. What is the difference between short run and the long run? Short run, there is a fixed cost. Long run, no fixed cost, all variable cost. Short run, you have already the four fixed cost curves, but in the long run, you have only two cost curves, AC and MC, two cost curves. Short run, you have AC, AVC, MC, AFC, right? Average cost. It's easy. Sometimes it is, you can say it is easy, right? This is the firm's output decision in the long run, two cost curves, MC and AC. Now, what will happen? The interesting thing, in the short run, we said firm will produce at a profit, or will produce at a loss, or will shut down in the short run. There is a shutdown point. But this is in the short run. But they will firm shut down temporarily in the short run. They will produce at a profit, produce at a loss, or shut down temporarily. But in the long run, you have started the business. This is after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, maybe 10 years time. Still, if you can't make the profit, this thing is to shut down the firm permanently. Long run, short run, different is short run shutdown is temporary. Long run shutdown is permanent. Shut down the firm, plant, go and do another business, maybe start selling lottery tickets. That is more profitable. Per ticket, you are getting 253 rupees per profit. So you just sell, if you say 300 tickets, to get 600 rupees per day, right? That is no problem. Permanently shut down. Now we'll discuss. Why is that? Because this is in the long run. So two decisions. You produce or shut down permanently. Short run, produce at a profit, produce at a loss, shut down temporarily. Yeah, but now the market price is very high, P1, MR equals MC, that is MR. MR equals MC, then the profit maximizing output is at Q1, right? Then, suppose for some reason in the long run, market price decreases. What are the reasons? The market, more and more firms comes, or demand decreases, something like that. So the either from supply shock or the demand shocks, due to supply side or demand side shocks, market price can come down. Right. Supply side shock, for example, these days, coconut prices are still high. It went up to 120, now slightly come down, right? Rice prices, yesterday I saw on the television, some of the traders, wholesale trade market, wholesalers at Peta market, they said in the coming months, there will be shortage of rice. Shortage of rice, supply side shock. Market price decrease, supply side shock, right? So the argument is we'll have to import rice, right? But the thing is now these days, most of this harvest is coming to the market, right? To the market, then it might take some time reduce the price, decrease the price. It might take, but in between you can have some high price regime, right? But before April, I think price will come down. No, yes, right. Then that is the thing. Supply side or the demand side shock, due to demand side or supply side shock, price can go up or down. From is a price taker. Initial price P1, profit maximizing output Q1, point of intersection of P1 and MC. What is P1? MR1, MR and MC. P is MR. Now, when price decreases up to this point, up to minimum point of the AC curve, up to P2, firm will produce at a profit. At a profit. But PT is a limiting price. When market price falls below PT, the average cost higher than the market price. For example, suppose P2 is here, price is here, average cost is above. So therefore, a firm cannot survive. This is in the short run. This is in the long run. Our firm will have to shut down the company permanently if market price falls below P2. P2. P2 is the long run shutdown price, you can say. If market price falls below P2, up to P2, firm will produce. If price goes down further, shut down the firm permanently. Because long run, maybe this is 3 months, 4 months, 1 year, 2 years time, still you can't make profit. So market price is not very high. Therefore, there's no point of conducting, being in the business. Shut up. Long run, these are the decisions, right? Now, short-term supply curve. Short-term supply curve. What is supply curve? Price versus quantity relationship. Now, we said in the short run, firm will supply MR equals MC, MR equals MC, MR equals MC, MR equals MC. Up to what point? Up to this point, firm will supply. This is a shutdown price. After that, firm will supply zero output. That's why it is vertical. Vertical. If market price falls below this thing, output zero, 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 zero. If market price above P3, firm will supply P3, intersection of P3 and MC, P3 and MC. So therefore, this is the section of the supply curve. This is the, so overall supply curve is a kink supply curve. We call it kink supply curve. It is the MC curve. Not the whole MC curve. Section of the MC curve above the minimum point of the AVC, otherwise if market price falls minimum point, it will be zero. So the supply curve, you are, it's a kink supply curve. Kink supply curve is broken into two. Below P3, it is MC curve. It is the supply curve. Below P3, vertical, zero output is produced, right? So short-term supply curve is equal to MC curve above the P3 curve. Not the whole MC, same section. Below P3, zero. In the short run, a firm should produce if and only if total revenue is not less than total variable cost. the then is the S curve show you the for the yeah point supply. Right. In the short run, a firm should produce if and only if total revenue is not less than total variable cost, or the price should not be less than the average variable cost, minimum point to the average variable cost. A necessary condition for the firm to be producing its output is that MR should equal MC. Supply curve shows the relation between quantity supplied and market price. For the price below minimum AVC, that is the shutdown price, firm will supply zero units. Price above AVC, sorry, it is cut and that's a small AVC, the firm will equate P and MC. In the short run, if the market price is above the minimum point of the AVC, firm will supply output taking MC. This this section. This red line is the supply curve. Short run. P3 is the shutdown price. Long run supply curve is, that is also MC curve, not whole MC, minimum point of the AC curve, up to minimum point of the AC curve, firm will supply. If market price falls below P2, firm shut down to company permanently. This case, if market price falls below P3, shut down temporarily. This short run, things will improve, wait and see policy. But here what will happen, and down permanently. Supply curve is also two sections. First section is the same as MC curve, coincide with the MC curve. The below P2, it is vertical, zero output is supply. A price taking firm's long run supply curve coincides with its long run MC curve above its long run average cost curve, minimum point to the average cost curve. For any price below the lowest point on the long run average cost curve, the firm will supply no output. Firm will supply no output. That is the long run supply curve. It is the supply curve, but not the whole supply curve. Some restriction conditions are there. Okay. Now we discuss how does a firm in the firm competitive market decide the profit maximizing output in the short run. How does the firm decide the profit maximizing output in the long run? Then we discuss the shape of the short run supply curve and the shape of the long run supply curve. Now we are going to discuss the relationship between long run to short run, movement from short run to long run. What will happen? Short run to long run. A competitive firm would make economic profit only in the short run. In the long run, economic profit will be zero. Right? Now this is a very important theorem. Theorem, you can say, firm in a competitive market would make economic profit only in the short run. In the long run, firm's economic profit will be zero. You can easily prove this. In the long run, firm's economic profit will be zero. They can make economic profit only in the short run. Before we discuss these three diagrams, let's see some examples from the real world situation. Now, for example, I'm residing in Kadavatanu, maybe long time ago, maybe 10 years back, let's say, the service station from Paliyagoda to Kadavata. Very few service stations. Let's say only three or four service stations. Service station, right? Car wash. Can say you service the car. Only three. Let's say four service station. Maybe let's say 2000. Let's assume it is four. Now 2020, there are about 25 service station, 25. Initially, 2000, there were 4. 2020, it is 25. Number of firms, number of service station has increased. Then, if you talk to one of the service station today, 2020, what is their complaint? What is their complaint? His business is very bad. He can't make any profit. Then we ask, why is that? There are so many service stations. You can't make any profit. Right? Now, most of the traders use this term. No profit. No profit is no point of in this business. No profit. Remember, if you can't make profit, if you don't make profit, if you can't make profit, why should be? You can ask the question, why? Are you in the business? No, they are making profit. They are making the accounting profit, not the economy profit, not the supernormal profit, right? They are in the balance sheet, they are making profit day to day. But this service station, they complain, okay, it's bad business, you can't make profit. Why is that? Though there are so many people have come to the industry. Number of service station increased from 4 to 25. What will happen? Their profit margin has come down. Maybe they are not making economy profit, but in their balance sheet, in their profit and loss account, they are making economic accounting profit, not the economy profit. Okay. Now you understand the scenario. In the short run, they can make economic profit, but in the long run, when more and more firms enter into this business, their economic profit will go down. Now we are going to illustrate this using graph. We are using these three graphs. This extreme left, you have this diagram for the industry. Middle diagram, firms' behavior in the short run. In the right, on the right, you have the diagram. That is firms' behavior in the long run. Now I'll go to board and explain these three diagrams. Right? Sorry, I have not. Earlier, you now nobody. Nobody discussing. I'm going to the board. Can you see the board? I'm going to the board now. You can't see, please tell me. Sometimes I do mistakes actually. I'm going to the board now. Explain that. I think I have done a mistake. Now you can see, now we discuss, of course, these three diagrams. Firms, short-run supply curve. Short-run supply curve is this section of the MC curve. Then firms, long-run supply curve. Long-run supply curve we discuss. The long-run supply curve. Then the last theorem. Okay, now we are going to prove this. Okay, anyway, we are going to prove this now. Now you go to the board. I'll go to the board. You can't see the board. Please tell me. Please tell me if you can't see the board. And we are going to prove a firm in a competitive market can make economic profit only in the short run. In the long run, firm's economic profit will be zero. We are going to draw three diagrams. One for the market, then firm, second one for the firm's behavior in the short run, third for the firm's behavior in the long run. Okay. I'll start now drawing this diagram. If you can't see the board, please tell me loudly, right? Okay. Now this is first industry. Second diagram, firm in the short run. Third diagram, firm in the long run. Q, BQ. Industry. Then you have right. Firm in the, this is the industry. Market, this is a firm in the short run. The long run. Right. Now, the market in market price is determined by the interaction between demand and supply. The market price. It's a P bar. In the short run, firm takes that price. P1 is MR. MR1. Short run. Demand curve. This is demand curve. Demand curve. Firm in the short run. Then you have the MC curve. Where is the profit maximizing output? Here. Q star. Profit. To show the profit, we go to the AC curve. AC curve is this. So this is the profit. AC, this is linear profit. Short run profit. We call it economic profit. Now what will happen? Initial price, demand curve, average cost, profit. EDN. Demand. Here it is, MC, MR, AC, let's say demand, or here also D, MC, MR, AC, right, okay. Now what will happen? Now this short run, in the short run, the other firms outside this industry, this is the industry, no? The industry. This is one of the firms. The industry, outside firms outside firms see these firms are making profit short term. They see now this firm, outside firms, they are not in the business. Complete outside business, they see, okay, now these firms in the short term, they are making profit. What is the response? They also want to enter into this market. They want to enter in this market. Are they permitted? Now I want you to ask a question. Can the new firms enter into this market? Are they permitted? Are they allowed or not? Tell me. Can they enter into this market? New firms, can they come into the market? Yes, please tell me. If so, why? Hello? Are they allowed? Are they permitted? Can they come into the market? New firms? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes? They can. Why is that? No entry restrictions. Entry is free. Any firm can enter this market. Now what will happen? Because this firm is making profit, more and more firms enter into this market. If they are initially, there were 1,000 firms, initial supply was depending on 1,000. Now what will happen? More and more firms enter into this market. Why is that? Existing firms are making profit. Now 1,100, 1,200, 1,300, more and more suppliers are coming. What will happen to the supply curve? Supply curve shifts. Supply curve starts shifting. Market price starts falling. In the long run, what will happen? In the short run, profit. In the long run, how do you explain from the short run to long run? More and more firms enter into this market. Why? Because the existing firm is making profit. Are they allowed? Yes, they can enter this market. Enter into this market. Now supply curve starts shifting. Let's say SS, S dash, 1,200 suppliers. Like that, then market price decreases. Market price decreases. Further drop in market price. If there is a price, still market price is here. There is a price, profit. More firms enter, supply curve shift, price decreases like that. Up to what point price decrease? Price decreases up to this point, minimum point of the AC curve. Up to P2. What is this P2? This P2 is this. Supply curve will shift up to this point. S dash. Maybe 1,500 firms, like that, supply curve shifts. Like a shift up to this point is P2. Now what will happen at this point? Average cost is like this. Marginal cost is like this. Market price is this. Output is this, Q2. What will happen? Revenue, same. Price into quantity. Cost, average cost into quantity. These average costs are also same. Total cost equals total revenue, therefore zero profit. Profit is zero. The market price decreases. Initial price, more suppliers coming, market price decreases. Market, more suppliers, supply curve shifts to the right. And the limiting point, market price will fall up to this point in the long run. In the long run. At that point, this is MC, AC, P2 equals MR, equal demand. This is a long run scenario. And market price there, as a result, what will happen? Total profit will be zero in the long run. So the firm could make economic profit in the short run. competitive firm could make economic profit in the short run. In the long run, economic profit will be zero. Revenue equals cost. Revenue same, cost same. Cost same. That is zero. Economic profit. Please think about economic profit, zero. In the short run, economic profit is there, but in the long run, economic profit zero. Why is that? More firms enter into this market. Supply increases. Market price decreases. So market price decreases up to minimum point of AC curve, long run AC curve. Then revenue equal cost. Revenue equal cost. You your profit will be zero. Right? That is important theorem. Sorry, very important theorem in competitive market. Competitive firm could make economic profit only in the short run. In the long run, the economic profit, I'm always using economic profit will be zero. Right? Okay. Why is that? That doesn't mean they are not making profit. Economic profit zero, but they are making what profit? What profit? Tell me, what profit? They are making what? What kind of profit? Accounting profit. What is economic profit? Revenue minus accounting cost minus opportunity cost. Right? Accounting cost. Economic cost. Yeah, I am not making economic profit. The economic profit is a different concept now. How do you get the economic profit? Total revenue minus accounting cost minus opportunity cost of factors of production. But when you say they are not making economy profit, that doesn't mean they are not making accounting profit, they do. Understand? Now I come to this service station example. Service people say this is not profit. No profit. I don't know this. More and more people have entered in the industry. Lots of service station. Now we have 25 service station. We can't make profit. We can't make profit. Right? We can't make profit. Right? Right. You can't make profit. What is the reason? More people enter. Market price. Market become more competitive. Market price has come down. It has come down to minimum point of the AC curve. That doesn't mean they are accounting profit. They are making accounting profit. Every day they are doing the service. So in the service, if you are not making profit, why do you be in the business? That's a very funny argument. No, they are making accounting profit. Day-to-day business, they are making profit. But if you adjust the profit for the opportunity cost of all the factors of production, maybe your profit is zero. I'm asking this question. Now we are going to this. Right. Now you can understand this, the diagram, right? The supply curve shifts initially. Market price PS, short run price, long run price PL, supply curve shifts. Why is that? In the short run, you have this firm is making profit, no? It's diagram. Then more and more firms enter into this market, supply curve shift. Shift, market price decreases up to the minimum point of the AC curve. At this point, total revenue equals total cost, profit zero. But here, profit is the small area. Right, okay. Now this competitive firm could make economic profit only in the short run. In the long run, its economic profit will be zero. Prove this using the basic framework. Now we have proved. You have to draw this diagram. Even in the exam, if they ask this theorem to you, prove, you have to draw these three diagrams and explain. Right. First question. Why do firms enter an industry when they know that in the long run, economic profit will be zero? That's a very interesting question. If they know in the long run, their economic profit will be zero, Why do they enter into this industry? What is the answer? Economy profit will be zero, but they can make accounting profit. Accounting profit is not zero. Therefore, they enter. As long as they can make accounting profit, they enter. The long run, economic profit will be zero. Once you deduct opportunity cost of factors of production also, you may not be able to make profit. But accounting profit, direct revenue, direct cost, there is a profit. But direct revenue, all the cost, no profit, economic profit, right? So that is the question. This last question number two, I am not going to discuss, but I can. Fixed cost is 100. Consider competitive firm cost function. C equals this. Q is the output. C is total cost. Cost is 100. Marginal cost, you differentiate this function with respect to Q. Marginal cost is 2Q. Like that, think about that. 2Q marginal cost. If the market price is 60, what will be the profit? So you make MC equals 60. MC equals 60. 2Q equals 60. Q equals 30. What is short-term charge? And actually, this question is once it was in the one of the past papers, but it's a bit you need some knowledge about the differentiation. Once you differentiate the cost function with respect to output, you get MC. MC is 2Q. Fixed cost 100. C equals 100 plus Q squared. No, fixed cost is 100. Answer to the first question. Marginal cost. Marginal cost DC over DQ. Differentiate the cost function with respect to output. 2Q. MC is 2Q. MC is 2Q. Right? Answer to the second question is MC. MC is differentiate cost function with respect to output. 2Q. You differentiate. If the market price is 60, market price is 60 means MR also 60. Price 60, MR 60. MC is 2Q. 2Q equals 60, Q equals 30. Profit maximizing output is 30. Marginal cost 2Q equals 60. Think about 2Q equals 60, Q equals 30. Profit maximizing output is 30. Then you can calculate profit also, revenue and the cost, right? The what is the short-term shutdown price? Shutdown price is the minimum point of the AC curve, ABC curve. You can calculate. If you are familiar with this differentiation and the cost curve, you can easily answer this question. First, part A answer is 100. Part B answer is 2Q. Part C answer is 30. Part D, I want you to check the draw this diagram and determine the shutdown price. Right, we finished the discussion on this one. Now we will go to the next lesson, that is monopoly, pure monopoly, other extreme of the market, other extreme of the market, pure monopoly, competitive market we discuss, right? Excuse me. Monopoly, pure monopoly. When you say pure monopoly, one firm, pure one. Then you can have other market, other monopolies. Maybe two firms control the 90% of the market. Again, you say they are called monopoly, not pure monopoly. Monopoly, right? So the two or three firms control the entire market supply. That is the aqua monopoly. When you say pure monopoly, only one firm. Central Bank of Sri Lanka. CB. Ports Authority. Yeah, the Ceylon Tobacco. One firm is responsible for the entire industry output. Pure monopoly. Now we said the pure monopoly or the monopoly firm is a price setter. price maker. Firm can decide the price. Pure monopoly can do this two ways, of course. Either they can set the price. My price is 100 rupees per unit. I am the monopolist. I am the only seller. I set the price 100. If you don't like, you don't just don't buy. You're the I know no substitute products. You have to come to you have to buy the stuff from my product from my company. My 100 rupee, my 100 rupee. That is the price set. Or I can manipulate this quantity side. I don't know anything about the. I don't announce anything about the price, but I simply cut down the quantity. I can control the quantity side. All when you cut down the quantity, what will happen? Market price increases by manipulating, changing, varying the quantity, or changing the price. You have the monopoly power. Therefore, monopolist can be said price setter or quantity setter, price maker or quantity maker. By quantity maker, by changing the quantity, then you know price will go up or down. You can see. So monopolist can be pure monopolist can be said price setter or the quantity setter, right? Now that's happening in, for example, now the OPEC countries. OPEC countries, it's a cartel, it's an oligopoly market. Now what do? Sometimes they announce, okay, OPEC, oil producing and exporting countries, they are organization. The Argentina, Saudi Arabia is a giant, then the Argentina, Venezuela, these companies, oil companies. So sometimes they announce, when oil price is coming down, 40, now it is around, these days around 50 rupees, no, $50 per barrel, 50, 60. Then when it comes down 40, 30, 20, what will happen? These countries, their export revenue will go down. Billions of dollars, they are earning billions of dollars, but then when market price decreases, their revenue goes down. Market price decreases. Profitability of these oil producing companies decreases. Not only that, these firms will be making losses sometimes, right? People's income will be falling. So the economic activity, economic growth will be coming down. So yeah, export earnings decreases. This economy is shrinking, decreasing, growth rate falling. GDP growth rate falling. Then what will happen? Demand for our labor decreases. Sometimes layoff. You go home. Because we are poor now. We are poorer than. Our growth rate is falling. Our income is low. So they are not increasing. You go home. Demand for our labor decreases. When oil price decreases, international oil price decreases, our labor market is affected. Understand? These are the linkages. Our about $6 to $7 billion of our foreign exchange, foreign assets, foreign reserves are coming from Middle East countries, right? So therefore, when these Middle East countries decreasing, shrinking, their growth rates are falling, economies are not performing, demand for labor decreases, sometimes layoff. Now, most of the country nowadays, what is happened is because this COVID pandemic, now these people are, their activities, their economies are shrinking, negative growth rates, very low growth rate. Now, some of our workers, foreign workers, the working, their housemates, they have to go home, they have to come back. Now, there are other problem is now when they're coming back, now our airports is not functioning properly, right? So the very slow process is there, bringing these Middle East people. They are coming, they are bringing, but very slow. At the same time, there's cost involved. They have to pay some airfare. They don't have airfare. If it is free of charge, you can get through embassies. Sometimes some period, some months, some flights are coming without charging anything from the passenger, Middle East worker. But most of the cases you have to pay, right? Sometimes if you are willing to pay, you have to pay the airfare, you have to pay the quarantine cost, you come and stay in the hotel, then you have to pay for the PCR test. That also is up to you. Now, most of the developed countries, that is the case, right? One of my friends, after this quarantine last month, he went back. He was stuck here. He was Sri Lankan. He had the citizenship in Australia. He was stuck with quarantine here in Sri Lanka. Then he decided to go back last month. Then I talked to him. You have to pay the airfare. Then you have to pay the hotel charges. You go to Sydney, you will be kept in a hotel. You have to pay the Then you have to pay the PCR cost and doing this PCR test. Then again, airport to hotel, therefore around the $10,000 you have to pay, right? Around $10,000 you have to pay, right? Altogether, it comes up to 1 million. 1 million rupees, Sri Lankan rupees. Normally, if you take a flight to Sydney, it's around return ticket, it was around 175 and 200,000, right? These times, around 400,000 one-way ticket, plus other cost, airport to hotel, you have to stay 14 days, that cost, then the PCR, conducted the FAA, everything is money. So altogether, he said that is around 1 million rupees, right? Because of that. Now, these things happening. Now, here also in Sri Lanka, those who are working abroad, then you are professional. If you want to come back to Sri Lanka, you have to incur this cost. If you are a Middle East worker, the government has made some arrangements to bring them into Sri Lanka free of charge. Sometimes you have to pay if you pay, airfare, PCR test, quarantine cost should be borne by the passenger, right? These things happen, right? We are talking about this, why do we go to this area? Yes, just this, right? Demand is coming down, Middle East demand, when oil prices are coming down, the cartel, the oligopoly, OPEC countries can cut down the quantity, supply oil production, then get the high price. Number one, if market price, oil price is coming down, once it went up to around, I can remember last year by September, November period, before that, oil price came down to, April, March period, just before this quarantine first wave, it went down to around 30. No demand, all the planes are grounded, right? Well, American, all these, Arizona desert, they have grounded, they have stopped this, landed all these planes in Arizona desert, right? Huge. Oh, no tourism, losses, right? These are things happening, right? So, monopolist either can control price side or the quantity side. By changing price, they can get a they can set the price or they can set the quantities, right? Now we are going to discuss this model. Introduction, pure monopoly, right? Basic assumption. Now introduction we discuss. A monopoly is a single firm that serves an entire market. Entire output is provided, supplied by this firm. The single firm faces the market demand curve. You see the market demand. Then you set the price or set the quantity. You know the demand. Monopolists know the demand curve. Can predict the demand curve. Using its knowledge of this demand curve, the monopolist makes a decision on how much to produce or how much to charge. Unlike perfectly competitive market. Now, this is a difference between competitive market and the monopoly. Competitive firm output, which is perfect substitute for competitor's output. Competitive firm's output, homogeneous. perfect substitute. But the monopolist output does not have closed substitutes. No closed substitutes. Underline that term, no closed substitute. There may be substitute, for example, electricity, hydropower. Electricity, you have coal power, then the solar power, nuclear power, biogas, so many things, substitutes. But they are not closed substitutes. At home, we all are using electricity. We don't use biogas. We don't use nuclear power. We don't use wind power. Sometimes we use solar power. Most of it now that is a trend. Solar power, the solar panels, you can fix a solar panel. Solar panel on the top of your roof. They do. That's a good market, growing market, emerging market is there. Now for the normal home is around 100,000, 900,000, 9 lakhs to 10 lakhs. You can fix a good solar panel set and generate electricity for your own house. If you generate more than your requirement, you can sell that to the main grid, sell that to the electricity board. Electricity board purchase that electricity. This kind of buyback arrangement is there. This is what. That is our, but still, they are not closed substitute. Monopolist, pure monopolist product. You can say lots of it's up to you, but no closed substitutes. How do you measure substitutability of whether the two goods are substitutes or not? What is the economic measurement? Tell me, what is the economic measurement to decide two goods A, B, substitutes or complements? What is the economic measurement? Tell me, economic measurement. We have discussed. How to decide two goods are substitutes or two good they are complements? How to decide? By looking at what? Hello? What is the economic measurement indicator? You all know, we have discussed. Good A and B, tea and sugar. Tea and coffee substitutes. How to decide in economics? How to decide? That's economic measurement. You have discussed that. Tell me, please. What is that? Yes? Hello? One of you want to answer? Tell me. It is okay. Cross price elasticity of demand. Very good. Thank you. When the good tea and the coffee, cross price elasticity of demand is positive plus. Right? That is that. Cross price elasticity, substitutability of two goods, two services are determined, are decided, commented using the cross price elasticity between these two goods or service. When they close substitute, what will happen? Cross price elasticity is still positive, but it is huge, plus 1,000, plus 10,000, plus 100,000. The two goods are close substitutes. Another two goods, let's say cross price elasticity, the plus 0.3. 0.3 plus 0.3. They are substitutes. They are not close substitutes. Another set of goods, pair of goods, cross price elasticity plus 1,000. Let's say C and D, good C and good D, cross price elasticity plus 1,000. Good A and B, cross price elasticity plus 0.3. Then what do you say? A and B are substitutes, C and D are substitutes. But C and D are closed substitutes. For closed substitutes, cross price elasticity positives and huge, very large. Right? So the for a monopoly firm, there are no closed substitutes, nature of the product. But the competitive firm, remember? Perfect substitutes. One firm output, paddy. We assume they are perfect substitute for the other firm's output. Also, now these are the difference between these two. Also, unlike perfectly competitive firms, output decision, the monopolist output decision will determine the selling price of the good. Firm is a price setter. But competitive firm, Computer industry firm, one single firm, cannot control the price. He's a price taker. He has to accept the price determined by the market, demand and supply. Competitive firm is a price taker. Monopoly firm is a price setter. Assumptions. In point four, seller is a price maker, or you can say price setter also. There are no close substitute for the product. Electricity. Hydroelectricity, hydropower, hydroelectricity. You can say biogas, wind power, solar power, they are substitute, but no close substitute. Either technological or legal barriers completely block entry. That is important. Remember, competitive firm industry, no entry barriers whatsoever. Any firm can enter into the market. Any firm in the market can exit from the market anytime. Entry, exit free. But pure monopoly is either technological or legal barriers are there. Nobody can't the entry for that example, you can't start the bank, commercial bank in month's time. No. So you very long process is there. You have to make application, then you have to put enough for the capital requirement is there, billions of rupees, 1.5 2.5 billion rupees, right? You have to deposit that in the central bank, then capital requirement is there. You have to show that show the evidences, then location, central bank. The bank examiners come and study your location, whether this security wise it is okay. They check and they rubber what kind of the deposits you are going to introduce, what are the interest rate structure, what kind of financial products you are going to do, what are your economic activities like that. It's a long process. Legal barriers are there. Right? Bank can refuse your requirement. No. You are not compelled, your application does not comply with this requirement. So we regret to inform you that we can't allow approve your requirement. That's all. Legal requirement or technological requirement. For example, technological means because of the technique. If you want to start a hydropower plant, at least it takes to construction period is maybe minimum of 5 years. Then you have to import this technology from another country, turbines. Then you setting up period is there. Then it might take another 5 to 6 years. Technological barriers are there, right? So the legal or the technological barriers block entry. Sellers do not behave strategically. Because you are the only seller. Why should you decide strategically? No. You don't have any competitors. No strategic behavior. Pure monopoly. Buyers are price takers. Poor buyers are price takers. We always price takers. You can't bargain with the price. You can bargain with only three wheel. If you then you take a three wheel. Right? Otherwise, you can't bargain. You have to accept the price. Three wheelers, of course, you can bargain. If the three wheel man say, okay, from Maradana to Baralla, if you say, okay, 200 rupees, you know it is not 200 rupees. Then you can buy, no, it is too much. 150. He said 150, no, it is too much. The 140, like that, bargaining process and effective. That is bargaining, but in the monopoly market, price is fixed. You have to accept the price, right? Buyers are price takers. Profit maximization. I will explain this diagram. Before that, I will explain another point here. Because you are a price setter, price setter, price maker, that's a very interesting point. Let's say competitive firm, price taker. You cannot influence, change the market price. But the monopolist, price setter, price maker. You can set the price. Not only that, you can sell your output at two different prices for two different customers. Price discrimination is there. You are a monopoly. Your pricing policy is okay. From households, you say unit price is 45 rupees per unit electricity. Industries, you say unit price, same electricity, maybe 60 rupees per unit. You can do, you sell the same product at two different prices for two different customers. That is called price discrimination. Selling the same thing at two different prices. Price discrimination, right? So because you are a price setter, you have that ability. Competitive firm doesn't have that ability. You have to charge the same price. But here, you sell two different prices. Electricity is a good example. I have discussed some other examples also, right? Price discrimination, we are going to discuss at the end of this lesson. There are three types of price discrimination: first degree, second degree, third degree, or market segmentation. Three types of price discrimination. We'll discuss this in detail. But monopolies can discriminate prices, sell the product at two different prices, because you are the price setter. Airline industry, price discrimination is there. From Colombo to London, let's say fare is around 200,000 rupees. Return ticket, 200,000. I don't know if it's about 200,000 rupees return. Then they say, okay, one day you travel. Stay night, you take the next flight tomorrow. Another these things, you are a tourist, pleasure traveler, right? You go to the Abu Dhabi or the Dubai, do some marketing, take another flight, stay 2 days, then go to London another 2 days time, right? And this time, they say, for the one day travelers, return 200,000. The other one, so the other one is maybe expensive, right? Expensive, 300,000, right? Then the business class and normal class. Normal class, business travelers and the economy class travelers. Two different prices. Business travelers, some of the economy class, let's say the fare is about 100,000. Business class, maybe 300,000. Business class. You get lots of the facilities. You own the compartment, the partitioning, your compartment, you own on the cabin. Is there? You get facilities. Some separate, the attendant is there anytime, you can call her, and the drinks, unlimited drinks, right? That any variety, lots of packages. Price discrimination, but you have to pay them. Big price difference. Price discrimination can be, we'll discuss what is price discrimination. Monopoly profit maximization. We said, let's discuss, remember about the competitive market. MR curve is horizontal, or the demand curve is horizontal. This MR curve or the AR curve is horizontal. Then you have U-shape MC curve. This is not this one, competitive market. U-shape MC curve, U-shape AC curve. Now what will happen? This is different. In this case, both AR and MR downward slope. Demand curve is downward sloping. MR curve is downward slope. MR curve is below the demand curve. Competitive market, demand curve, AR curve, MR curve, same, perfectly elastic, horizontal. Now this is one of the differences. Okay.
I did it.
Then the demand curve is downward sloping, MR curve is downward sloping. Competitive market, demand curve, MR curve same, horizontal. Now MC curve, upward sloping. MC curve U-shape. AC curve U-shape. Now we'll go to the board and explain. Can you see the board now? Can you see the board? Hello? Hello? Can you see the board? Hello? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I'm going to go now. Please ask any question. This is a two-way discussion. Don't hesitate to ask questions. Ask question, comment. You can say, sir, could you please explain that again? We can't understand. I can't understand. Well, this is no problem. Otherwise, there's no point on having this class. Your feedback, your questioning is very important. Right. Competitive or the monopoly market. Monopoly market. Nice. Demand curve. It is the AR curve. Now there's a difference between demand and MR curve. MR curve is demand and MR curve. Competitive market, remember? Competitive market. MR, AR, demand, price, same. Here it is MR, AR different. MC curve, in both cases it is U-shape. Then what is the profit maximizing output? At what point? That indicates the profit maximizing output. At the profit maximizing output, MR equals MC.
MC.
MR equals MC. Right. This point. MC, MR. Let's say monopoly, QM. QM. Output. Here also, competitive firm, the competitive price, quantity. Then, if they produce this output, at what price monopolies could sell this product? You go to the demand curve. Demand curve. This is the price, demand curve indicates the price, PM. Demand curve. This is the profit maximizing output. But here what will happen if they produce quantity, price is same. Here the MRMC is same, here the MR equals MC, at this point MR equals MC. But market price is different. Market price and the MC, there's a gap, MR gap, MC gap. But in this case, market price and MC same. Marginal cost and the price. If the marginal cost of production is 80 rupees, market price also 80 rupees. Competitive firm. This time, if marginal cost is 80 rupees, market price is higher. There's a wedge gap between the price and the marginal cost. That's why it's called the monopoly. Marginal cost 80. You sell, price charge, price higher than the 80. Monopolies can do that. Then what will happen? Profit. To check the profit, the we need the average cost curve. Average cost curve is this. You share. Yes. What is the average cost of this output? This point. Average cost. Average cost. SEM. SEM. A. CAC, yes. MRM, sir. What is the profit? Price into quantity. Total revenue. Price this into that. Price into quantity. Total revenue. Average cost into quantity. Total cost. Average cost into quantity. Total cost. Therefore, profit is this. Monopoly profit. Understand? This is the diagram. Now you can understand this. Monopoly is a profit maximizing decision. How is it along this axis? You see. Right? This is the diagram. Always think about this competitive diagram, firms, competitive market, perfect competitive the firm and the monopoly firm. You can draw these two diagrams, you can compare. Right? That is the monopoly diagram, basic model. Diagram is very important. In the examination, they should be able to draw this diagram correctly. Now we go to the total revenue, price into quantity, PM into QM, total cost, average cost into quantity. I will explain that. Then, monopoly profit, TR minus TC, PM minus AC, PM is this, AC is the small area, PM minus AC into QM, small area, PM minus AC is, PM is the, this one, average cost is this vertical distance, gap between these two, into QM, is the profit, monopoly profit, right, okay. Then give example for monopoly markets in Sri Lanka. Draw, now these are question, homework question. You can say the draw demand curve faced by competitive firm horizontal. Draw demand curve faced by monopoly. Competitive firm is called a price taker. You know, explain. It's a homework question. Monopoly firm is called a price maker. Explain. Can you also say that a monopoly firm a quantity maker? Yes. Monopolies could control either price or the quantity. Set the price or set the quantity. What is the economic indicator of two substitute goods? Cross price elasticity of demand. Two cross substitutes. Cross price elasticity positive, but large. I gave you some example. Think about that, this example. Monopoly price discrimination. Now this one. Because you are a monopolist, you are a price setter, you can do so many things. Right? You can do so many things. You can sell the product at two different prices for two different consumers. That is called price discrimination. The practice of charging different consumers different prices for the same good is defined as price discrimination. It is price discrimination. But I will ask the question. Petrol prices, 100, I can't remember the price now. Liter price, let's say 100, 125 in Colombo. 125 Colombo. Anuradhapura 125 and 10 cents. Liter, price of a liter of petrol is 125, 95 octane, 125, Anuradhapura 125 and 10 cents. Is this price discrimination or not? Why do they charge 10 cents? Why do they charge 10 cents? Why? What is the 10 cents? Is that a price selling petrol at two different prices? By that definition, it is, you can say it is price discrimination. No. Why is that? This 10 cents comes from where? Why there is this 10 cents? Tell me. Tell me. What is their 10 cents? Petrol price, understand, petrol price, Colombo, 125 rupees per liter. Anuradhapura, 125 and 10 cents per liter. Why there is 10 cents? What is this 10 cents?
For transportation?
Transportation cost. That is good. Very good. Thank you. Transport cost. Right? It is not price discrimination. If you charge over and above that price transportation cost, maybe it is price discrimination. Here it is 125. If the service station sell, it is 126 rupees. 127 rupees, 125 and 50 rupees, over and above the transport cost. Then that becomes price discrimination. Understand? It's applicable. Transport cost is there. That's why you... if you add transport cost, it is not price, over and above that. Right? So the CBI charges low electricity tariff. Price for industries should be other way around, of course. Other way around, right? Households pay lower price than industries, right? Higher it should be. Banks give higher interest rate margin for senior citizens than to other. This is a good example. Senior citizens like myself, right? Senior citizens. Earlier, that scheme was there, 0.5 or 1% margin when compared to another person, yeah, normal customer. Banks give, that is price discrimination. If normal customer is getting 10, now it is, nowadays interest rate is very low, not 4%, 4.5%, the senior citizens might be getting 5%. 4.55, this 0.5 margin is for senior citizen. That is price discrimination, interest discrimination. movie theaters usually charge lower fares to senior citizens than to other people. Actually, this is in most of the developed countries, England, USA, now the Australia. Now this package is, if you are senior citizen card, like identity card, bank ATM card, they have senior citizen card. Senior citizen card. Apply this, get a senior. If you produce the senior citizen card at the theater fair, theater, the entrance, you are charged lower price. Other customers, normal price. That is, the movie theaters usually charge lower fares to senior citizens than to other people. You have to produce your senior citizen card, otherwise you can't. Not the identity card, senior citizen card. Pharmaceutical companies frequently charge different prices in different countries for the same drug. Same drug, right? Germany. Now, most of the drugs, medicines to Sri Lanka. Have you checked this, packaging? Coming to Sri Lanka, what are exporting countries of medical items, medicine items, drugs, the pharmaceutical product? Yeah? What are these pharmaceutical products coming from where? India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, regional countries. We don't get the wholesale, you don't get prices from the drugs from UK or Germany, very rarely. Right? They're expensive, same drug, they're expensive. Two different companies, they charge different prices. Now the India is now this emerging country in the region for these pharmaceutical products. They are becoming monopoly power, monopolizing this sector, right? By the medicine, small drug, medicines, see the pack. The it's a producer of India, they give the address, Bombay or Assam, the Andhra Pradesh, some of these cities given, right? India or Bangladesh. Or the Pakistan, that is three major countries. You are not getting I am taking some medicine for the thyroxine. Earlier thyroxine, it was the UK product was there, English product was there in the market. Now Argentina, so they are imported from Argentina thyroxine. This drug was coming, thyroxine to Argentina. Day before yesterday, I was checking that drug was not in the market. The Argentina product, no drugs. Yesterday, I went to this pharmacy. They asked, this girl said, now we have the Indian product. Indian product is there, right? Now, they have come to the market. They have come to the market, thyroxine. Maybe, who knows that sometime in future, these Argentinian products might not be in the market, right? You have to go for Indian products, right? That is different prices. Now, India is emerging. India is monopolizing the sector now, drug market, manufacturing industry. Pharmaceutical companies frequently charge different prices in different countries. That is price discrimination. Same drug, two different prices, right? Different prices. Expressway management, this is another example relevant to Sri Lanka, charges different fares for different types of vehicles. Cars, other heavy vehicles, the containers, they charge different charges. For same distance, Colombo to Matara, Colombo to Kadavattu to Kottava, from my area, my village town, Kottava, different prices. That is price discrimination. The pricing of detergent. Now this is very interesting. This is also a price discrimination. Take the pricing of detergent. 1 kilogram pack, washing powder, let's say. Washing powder, let's say 100 rupees. 2 kg pack is 150. What is the unit price? Unit price is 75 per kilo, not 200. If you buy 1 kg pack, you can buy 100 rupees. 2 kg pack is 150. Then the kilo price is 75, not 200. 75. That is also price discrimination. That is also coming in price determination. Why is that? Because it depends. If you have the weekly requirement of the washing powder, right? Is let's say the detergent is 1 kg, you buy 1 kg. If your household requirement per week is 2 kg, 2 kilogram, you will go for 2 kg pack, paying 150. So this kind of pricing policy is called the second degree price discrimination. Because second degree price discrimination, the monopolist announce pricing policy. 1 kg pack 100, 2 kg pack 150. 3 kg pack 180, 60 rupees per kilo, right? Depending on your requirement, depending on a requirement, you go for one of these price schedule, right? Pre-announce the price schedule, second degree price schedule. If you go to business trip, 1 day after, leisure trip, another day after. So companies announce us, same day they return, this is our price. After 2 days time return, you return on 2 days time, this is the fare, low fare. Same day return, high price. Discrimination. The airlines announces, pre-announce their pricing policy. Then depending on your requirement, whether you want to come back to Colombo same day or 3 days time, you go for one of the pricing charity. That is called the second degree price discrimination. Pricing of fares, I say, vacation fare, long stay is lower than the business trip, short stay. Fares for the same sector, Colombo, Bangkok. Right. Above 6 and 7 called price discrimination based on self-selection criteria. 6 and 7, I said, I use the second degree also. That is called the self-selection. Self-selection means you decide. If you are a business trip, short stay, you pay higher fare. Long stay, you pay lower fare. Same sector, Colombo, Bangkok. Right? Self-selection, airline announces, company announces their pricing policy. Then you yourself, customer himself decide, go for one of these schemes. That is called self-selection criteria. Self-selection criteria, right? It's also second degree self-selection criteria. Okay, now we'll stop at this point. Then we have a few more slides to discuss. Next week we'll finish. Saturday, we'll see you on Saturday. Please go through this, my first note, price perfect competition and the monopoly. The next week, I might discuss the past paper. One of the past papers, the 2020 or 21 January or 20 September paper. I will upload those two. Then we can discuss so many questions. So far we have discussed micro, almost finished. Next session we are going to start the macro, right? By Saturday we will finish the micro, right? Last section we will discuss the past paper. Okay, thank you very much. We stop now. Thank you. Hello. Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you hear me?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.